a mountain-sized rock called the Kumano Pluton, buried deep beneath the coastline of southern Japan, may be acting as a lightning rod for the region's mega quakes. An international team of scientists led by the University of Texas at Austin, funded in part by NSF, has for the first time created a 3D visualization of the rock and how it could be diverting tectonic energy that causes earthquakes. The team created the 3D model of the entire underground rock formation using 20 years of seismic data and harnessing the processing power of the Lone Star 5 supercomputer. The system is one of the world's largest supercomputers, located at NSF's Advanced Computing Center on the UT campus. This visually detailed map not only sheds light on the Pluton's influence on how and where earthquakes occur, but this study demonstrates how big data could revolutionize earthquake science. The team sees others using their methods to make detailed 3D images in areas like Cascadia in the U.S. Pacific Northwest, New Zealand, and Northwest Japan, all known to host the world's largest earthquakes. This mini cheetah learns to run fast, really fast. The MIT bot has set a new speed record of 3.9 meters per second, or almost 9 miles per hour, the highest speed ever recorded. But that's not all. It also learns as it navigates and adapts to challenging terrain like this gravelly hill, and can recover from trips and collisions better than previous non-learning systems. The mini cheetah can even adapt to changes in the robot itself, such as a disabled leg. The MIT team says this robot is an example of a more practical way to build a robot with many diverse skills. Tell it what to do and let it figure out how. This advanced learning is part of current research at NSF's Institute for Artificial Intelligence and Fundamental Interactions. This approach is not only relevant for robots, but also for operations of complex physics experiments, like the LIGO gravitational wave detector, where AI can help it adjust to changing conditions. Be sure to subscribe and click the like button for more research news. This is NSF Science Now. I'm Dina Headley.